Steam Whistle Brewery.
Same here.
Same thing?
Yeah.
Thanks, excellent, excellent. Anyone else know? Anyone come from outside of Toronto? Yeah, great job. Well, excellent, nicely done. You?
Windsor.
Windsor, nicely done, excellent. Everyone else, I'm guessing, is from Toronto? What's that? Kingston, nice, excellent. Is there anyone from Ottawa? No? That's where I'm from. Just double check to make sure. Go, Sens, go. Anyone? No? Yeah, hey, yeah, excellent, good. Sorry, no, it's okay. Not that I don't like the Leafs, but I don't like the Leafs. So, nice. I probably just
dropped
the frame right there, but oh well, it's all right. 6 years in the city, I'm still alive, so it's all right. Nice, guys. So, welcome to the brewery, guys. Hope you guys have a good time. I know you guys are going to have a great time. Yeah, so, for those of you with picture taking devices and things like that, you can take as many pictures as you guys would like. We've got nothing to hide here at the brewery, so you guys snap away. If you guys got any questions or anything close to the tour, you let me know, and I will answer to the best of my ability. But if you guys need me to speak up or anything, then you let me know that as well, and I will try, okay? Especially when we get on top of the production line, if we're still working, it might get a little noisy, okay? So the way we kind of start here, is anyone here ever heard of Upper Canada Brewing before? Pretty sure the people from Australia have never heard of it. No? Well, for those of you who don't know what it is, Upper Canada Brewing was a microbrewery co-founded by a man named Frank Heaps back in 1981 up in Guelph, Ontario. Hooray! Nice done. Yeah, so back in 1981, Upper Canada Brewing was founded. Throughout the course of the 80s, as the 80s kind of went along, it became one of the largest microbreweries in all of Canada. It was actually number one for about 4 years. Although, unfortunately, in 1996, when Upper Canada Brewing went public, a bigger Canadian brewery came in and bought out Upper Canada. Know where that big Canadian brewery is?
Molson?
It's not Molson. That's it, Sleeman's, that's it. That's it. Sleeman's came in 1996, bought out Upper Canada Brewery. They went in there and they said, hey, employees of Upper Canada, thank you guys so much for all your years of hard work and dedication, but you're all fired. They fired everyone at Upper Canada Brewing. And amongst the people who were fired was Frank Heaps' son, Cam Heaps, and his two best friends, Greg Taylor and Greg Cromwell. So these three best friends, Cam, Greg, and Greg, you know, having just recently been fired from the brewery, not feeling at the top of their game, what did they do in true beer drinking style? They picked up a whole bunch of beer, they picked up their camping equipment, and they went on a nice camping and canoe trip up in Algonquin Park, which is northern Toronto. So, they were sitting around the fire that night, enjoying a beer, and they were thinking about what they're going to do in the future, not having any plans because they were fired. themselves and said, guys, what are we doing? We don't even need them. We're going to create our own brewery. It's going to be called Three Fired Guys Brewing. That was the very first name Steam Whistle ever had. It was Three Fired Guys Brewing. They thought of it right there on the spot, sitting around the campfire, and they fell in love with it. So they brought it back to Toronto. They ran it by Frank Heaps. Frank Heaps said, guys, I don't think Three Fired Guys Brewing is the best name to market a beer and kind of distribute it around. I disagree personally. I think it's an excellent name. But I think from a marketing standpoint, it wasn't the greatest name for a beer. So they dropped it. And what they did is they came back here to Toronto. They were hanging out in the distillery district of Toronto over there in the East End. They were hanging out on the rooftops of one of the old buildings enjoying a beer. It was around 7 o'clock in the evening on a Wednesday. They were taking a look at the beautiful skyline of Toronto. And one of the things they noticed is that a lot of business people were still hard at work behind their desks, even at 7 o'clock in the evening. And they're like, man, that ain't right.